Hey guys, welcome back to Pokemon Sapphire. It's been a long while again, as I usually start off these videos with that, but I'm finally in the mood to record some more Pokemon. The only bad thing is I completely forgot to check the last video that I uploaded to see what the hell I was doing. But there's something that I wanted to do. I wanted to catch a new member of my team, which I think can be found in this patch of grass. Unless it is a Ruby exclusive. Which I hope it's not, because I'd really like to catch this Pokemon. I looked it up on Cerebi.net. I know most people use like Bulbapedia and stuff like that, but I use Cerebi, and it doesn't learn terribly good moves on its own by leveling up. So I'm probably gonna have to use TMs on it, which I'm fine with, especially since we'll be getting a really good electric TM once we beat Watson. But hopefully I can find it. Hopefully it's in this game. That'd be really crappy if it's not in this game and if it's Ruby version exclusive and not in Sapphire. But I can hope. And I hope it's on this route because I think it is. I'm pretty sure I've run into this Pokemon in this patch of grass before. And no, it's definitely not Plusle. I'm gonna speed this up a little bit as I continue searching for this guy. Or girl, I'm not sure which. Is this, please be it. Yes! All right, I'm gonna catch an Electrike. I've never used this thing on my team, but looking at its stats, it looks pretty decent. Like I said, it doesn't really learn many good moves upon leveling up. So like I said, I'm probably going to have to use TMs on it. So that's just what I'm gonna do. So I think Manectric is a pretty decent Pokemon. I know that Watson uses one, I believe. Hopefully this isn't a crit. Okay, good. I'm just gonna like lob a Pokeball at it and hopefully it catches it, because I don't wanna stay here for days on this thing. Cause I need to level it up and get it ready for other battles, because my Grovyle and my Tailow are pretty high level just because I only had two Pokemon with me like this entire time. But yes, we caught it. I'm not gonna give him a nickname. I've been so bad with nicknames. Let's see, it's a lightning Pokemon. Electrike runs faster than the human eye can follow. The friction from running is converted into electricity, which is then stored in this Pokemon's fur. Alright, caught Electrike. Not gonna give it a nickname because I suck with that. But I think, isn't the name Raider in Slateport? I think he might be, but I could be wrong. But I'm kind of debating, holding like a little, not really a contest, because I mean, winning the chosen nickname doesn't seem like very much of a prize, but I'm just terrible with coming up with nicknames in general. So I was thinking of just asking you guys what you think some good nicknames would be. Obviously try to keep them PG, because I really don't want to name grass Pokemon like marijuana or weed or Mary Jane. I think that's silly, but other nicknames that you guys can think of, I'd be more than happy to consider. I think I already took care of the Devon goods, gave them to Captain Stern, right? I don't have any key items, so I'm assuming so. And I have hiccups, so that's great. I need to train this Electrike, so let me put this guy in the front. And actually, since I delivered the letter to Steven, I'm actually going to head back to Rustboro City, I believe, and get an EXP share from, what is his face? I'm pretty sure it's Mr. Stone, but I haven't battled any of these trainers. Does Electrike even know an electric type move right now? Only Thunder Wave. That's pretty bad. I don't think I have any TMs that I can teach it. Yeah, none of these would really be of use to poor little Electrike. Not until I beat Watson, I guess. Which is unfortunate. I should probably look up and see if he learns Thunder Shock at some point. It'd be nice if he did, because then I can just like clear out all these sailors and stuff like that fairly easily. But until then, I need to head back to Rustboro City and get the EXP share. So I will meet you guys back in Slateport City after I have gotten the EXP share. I'll see you in a second. All right, so I'm back in Slateport City. I have the EXP share. I have it on Manectric, Electrike, and I accidentally ran into this guy. Also, when I was over there back near Petalburg and Rustboro City getting this, I actually went through the wooded area and used Cut. I also caught a Nincada, I think that's how you pronounce his name, and I got the Miracle Seed in the Petalburg Woods from a girl that you can reach once you get the Cut HM. So I did that so I can give it to Grovyle. And we beat this guy and he's not happy about it. He only gives us 56 Poké Dollars because he's a little kid. And, alright, so like I said, I have the EXP share attached to, Electrike. I keep wanting to say Manectric. I actually keep wanting to say, like, Electros, which is so far off, it's not even funny. But, yes, I'm going to be training up Electrike, not Electros, by battling with Grovyle and letting him just kind of leech the experience with the EXP share. And here we have like a crazy Pokemon lady or whatever her name is, Pokefan. A crazy Pokefan who has a Plusle and more than likely a Minun if I remember correctly. It's effective, just not that great. I'm just gonna use Quick Attack then. Poor Grovyle doesn't really have much going for him right now. A Minun, no, I won't switch, even though I probably should. Yeah, like, poor Grovyle isn't that great against these guys. Poor little guy. Give me some health back. Thank you, even though you have, like, a berry. Just defeat him, please. Thank you. Oh, he likes Tracker to level 13. Very nice. Now, if only he would learn an Electric-type move that wasn't Thunder Wave. And I'm actually just gonna heal my poor guy up really quickly. Some not check tag. I hated how they did that. Like, why do you put check tag up there? When I mash the A button, I don't want to deal with that. Let's get rid of his paralysis, and then give him an orange berry or two. And give him another one. Not check tag. See, I did it again. Like, it's just so bad. But yeah. I caught a Nincada to be an HM slave, basically, so he can learn Cut, so I can get to different areas. But let's actually go up here. I think there's a decent item up here. I also need to sell some of my items, like the X accuracies and X attacks and X defense and stuff like that. I never really use those. Like, I might consider using them in, like, wow, guard spec. I'll be selling that too. But I generally don't really use those. I could see using them in, like, let's say, like, a solo run, because they could be extremely beneficial. And I've seen, whenever I see them used, I see them used in, like, a really poopy Pokemon solo run. And I always see them in special competitive battles. It's like, I don't even know if you're able to customize that so you can use items in competitive battles. I never really got into that scene, but if so, then that's where I've seen them. If not, I just see people use Baton Pass and basically kind of like use X attacks and X defense and stuff like that. It's like the non-item equivalent of doing that. But yeah, that's pretty much how people sweep other stronger Pokemon with like a Magikarp or like a Weedle or something. Cause I've seen it done before and it is crazy. It's very interesting. Probably takes a really long time to set up and I feel really bad for the poor unfortunate soul that got sweeped by like a Magikarp, but it happens. It definitely happens and hopefully my Electrike will not die in this battle. I'm gonna focus this Plusle because I think this Plusle, they both use Helping Hand, I believe, in the beginning. But I'm just gonna howl a little bit and get my attack up. Who the heck uses? I could have sworn one of these guys used Helping Hand, but I guess not. And of course he's gonna lower my attack as I'm trying to raise my attack with Howl, so that's nice. I'm gonna kinda skip through here a little bit. Let's use Quick Attack, why not? Let's continue using Howl a little bit. There we go. There was the Helping Hand. But he's just gonna continue to use a freaking growl, which really sucks. So I'm just gonna go to using tackle on him. Because there's really no point in me trying to howl when the other freaking Pokemon, whether it be Plusle or mine, and the one that doesn't use Helping Hand, just uses growl. So it just negates whatever howl that I do, which is really unfortunate. And I just got paralyzed. Are you kidding me? Okay. That was a good crit. I'll give that to him. let's hurry up and hope that we can kind of get through this. I'm just gonna speed this up because it's just one Pokemon now and blah, 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 blah. And this is terrible. This is taking forever. Yeah, it'd be nice if I had a move that was a little better than like Quick Attack or Scratch. And they lost. Unfortunately, Electrike didn't grow another level, but that's all right. Let's hurry up and take down this guy. I think I actually might save most of these trainers for off-screen, because I don't believe Electrike evolves until level 26, if I remember correctly. So it's really not a giant deal. I don't think anything spectacular happens with his leveling up process, except for obviously like a few moves. But are you kidding me, Skinny? Are you kidding me right now? Why would you do that to me? And you're gonna heal? What do you... You have an Aurum Barrier? Yeah, you do. Like... This guy. And... Okay, at least he didn't fall for Skitty's attract bullcrap. That's all I care about. But now, since I'm gonna use, like, Quick Attack, if it doesn't kill me... I'm actually gonna switch Pokemon here really fast. I'm gonna switch to Talo. Because... Oh my god... This thing is so annoying. I'm gonna spam Quick Attack and hope that I don't die, which I might. Nope, no I didn't. All right, good. Anyway, oh cool, Electrike grew to level 14. Still hasn't learned a good move yet, but like I was saying, I think I'll just mostly level him up.